Welcome back to Conrad Stevenson's Paranormal PI. And we're finished with our first investigation of the Polk House. Okay, EMF readings, temperature readings, audio recordings. And we got exactly one photo. PM closed. T-shirt, hat, mug.
Spirit, turn off the music.
Alrighty.
I didn't want to do that.
Spirit, turn on some music.
Okay.
Our bracing king is learning tool, but one college. Okay. Polk Street. Oh! Evergreen Lane. Interesting. That's what's going on here. Okay. So, what's over here? Bathroom. Wonder what would have happened, like, if it turns out that Conrad is a ghost or something. Okay. So let's look at our... Well, we can look at the... same thing. We're going to look at the archives. Evergreen Lane, we don't have anything new. And there are 1, 2, 3, 4 more... pieces. I think before we move on, finish out Polk Street. Oh, hello. Hello. This is a lot. Okay. This is everything. Okay. Interesting. Divorce agreement? No. Wagner's. The Wagner's. The built. Yeah, okay. And then sold. Let's see. Helen... Age 58, Polk Street, died peacefully in her sleep at home on Friday, November 13th. Helen was born in New Adelon, February 1906. She married the lover of her life, Harold Wagner, on August 25th, 1924, at the age of 17. And the two lived together happily for over 4 years. Energetic and good-hearted, Helen spent her career working as a nurse and only recently retired. She was a devout Christian and an active parishioner of St. Joseph Cathedral, which benefited tremendously from her tireless volunteer work. I like the way they blank out the faces so they don't have a specific impression. Surviving Mrs. Wagner are her husband, 2 children, Richard and Chad Wagner, 3 grandchildren, Kimberly, Eric, and Susan Wagner. Funeral services will be held for close family and parish members at 10 a.m. on November 16th, 1964 at St. Joseph Cathedral. Burial at St. Joseph Cemetery. Flowers and condolences may be delivered to Harold Wagner at their family home on Polk Street. Okay. David Allen, 31. Died unexpectedly while spending time with friends. He was born in New Adelon, January of 1984. The son of Charles Allen, a true artist since early childhood, David enjoyed sculpting and painting in his free time. He was also an avid reader and worked as a clerk at Noble Books, Barnes & Noble, a local shop that he frequented as a young boy. Surviving David is his father, Charles Allen's. Funeral service will be held at 10 a.m. on August 15th, 2015, at the Fellowship of Congregational Church. Burial will be at Spruce Street Cemetery. As home on Monroe Street. Mental health. Concerned enough for eval. Consumer denies current thoughts. Homicidal. Of other directed harm at this time. Past suicide, no. Past aggression, had thoughts. Unstable living arrangement. Let's see here. Why he or she has feelings of severe depression. Oops. Dangerous self and others. Fear of losing control. Current substance abuse. Risk assessment of 2 weeks. Deborah Allen. Okay, Deborah Allen is right here. Lynn Allen. Okay, they divorced. Then he got married again. Then Deborah Allen got evaluation. Yeah, that was August 10th. This is before that. Received a call from a resident on Polk Street stating they heard loud, angry screaming from the house next door and loud bang shortly after. Wanted to remain anonymous. Arrived at the residence around 6:02 p.m. and a woman answered the door. She identified herself as Deborah Allen and remained calm and respectful while we discussed. I asked if anyone else was home. She replied that her stepson was in his room. I asked if I could talk with him. She answered yes. The boy identified himself as David Allen, who would die later, and said he was 10 years old. He appeared to have been crying, had fresh scratches on both sides of his neck. When I inquired about my observation, he said his allergies were bothering him. He had no idea how he got the scratches. I did not press him further. Asked Deborah about my observations of David, and she replied, "You know how boys are. They're always roughhousing about something." She denied having anything to do with his tears or scratches. Viewed all known inhabitants, not enough evidence to confirm an incident or crime. But David died later, so it's probably not David. Light MLS. Okay. Let's look at... I have 100 credits. Laser pen. Well, I've been known to use... Okay. I could buy the laser pen. EMF pod. Trigger to eliminate. Okay. Sensitivity high. We'll sound at the field's thermal devices. We already own this. Audio devices. Own that. Remote capabilities none. Sensitivity high. Parabox. Paravox. Surrounding environment. Entities to access its database of words. So that would be for things that release and exorcism. We got that already. I could get this. Autocam. Camera quickly snaps action shots until passed. It is easy to use interface. It'll automatically remote capabilities. Okay. So you set it up and it will automatically. I think I could buy this. What I would love to do is save up to get mini Gauss-meter is what we have. What I would like to do is to save up to get the EMF pod, I think. But let's go here. Let's go to the archives on Evergreen. Get Carter had a temper. Children's illnesses. Many families, many memories. Remodeling provokes activity. Okay. And close this. Go back to the inbox. And we'll go do this and go and check out that garage. No admittance, staff only. There is Jefferson Street. But we haven't been invited to Jefferson Street. The Bar Harbor light. Okay, well, they're here. They light up. So we could. We've heard about them. That's why. Okay. Ghost investigation progress. We didn't actually look at kitchen ghost. No. Let me check something real quick. Exit map. Let's look at the audio. Okay, perpetual presence. How do I change the speed? Shadow, little boy blue.
What's that?
What's that? Ghost in the garage. I thought I had more audio than that, to be honest. Oh, okay. Let's go do this.
View casino. View casino. He's coming.
He's coming.
I just won't die. Why, my boy?
I hate you.
I hate you.
Don't
don't say that.
Who are you? Wish she'd leave. We were happier before.
We were happier before.
We were happier before.
I'm here. Make her leave.
What's yours?
Let's see. So, I guess the last two don't really matter. Go. Okay, yeah, there's yellow. There's yellow. Yeah, I can't go anywhere but. Okay. So I want to go out to the garage this time.
It seems like the Wentz family isn't worried about their safety. Although it does seem like they're pretty startled when experiencing something they think is paranormal. I'm sure I'll be able to find enough evidence to support their claims and put their minds at ease.
Go over here and we could. Warren's suicide. Louise noted that her son was not the same person after coming back from the war. Witnessed horrible things while he was away at war. His unit was in the thick of horrendous bloody fighting. Once he came home, the trauma was something he could not escape. He was filled with nightly flashbacks and would awake feelings of terror like he was still in the trenches. His family saw the immense him. He returned home without many of his friends as they were left behind and buried in the soil of foreign land. After a few years of being home, he became despondent. Depended on habits he could not break away from. His family tried to console him, but ultimately could not alleviate his pain. In 1961, at the age of 37, he gave in to sadness and took his own life at the very same garage he and his father bonded over. Oh dear. Stay there, please. Stop moving around. Where were you? Did you move back over here?
These temp readings are unusual. That was a very unusual noise. I'll keep that as evidence.
Okay. something of who's out here. Obvious before. Come on back. That's locked. Might be able to from the outside. That's locked. Trying to find that temperature change. Actually, hey, there's a thing over there. Doesn't appear to be a information, though. Imagine there should be. Please stay here.
Something is going on here. These temperature readings are definitely paranormal.
There you are.
That's extraordinary audio evidence. Is there anyone here who would like to speak with me? Is there anyone here who would like to speak with me?
Okay, come on.
Is there anything you'd like to tell me? Is there anything you'd like to tell me?
Little boy blue.
Do you know why I'm here?
That's Polk Street, though.
Do you know why I'm here? How many people are here other than me? How many people are here other than me? Is this your home? Is this your home? Why are you here? Why are you here? Can you tell me your name? Can you tell me your name?
Yeah, let's try EMF. Why am I not getting a response from there? That's the lawnmower. Then again, oh, it's the battery in the lawnmower. Ooh. No, it moved. It didn't finish. See if I can find that before I switch videos. Okay, come on. Yeah, the battery from the car is not causing anything. Come on. It was almost done. But yeah, the video is getting kind of late. I'll see you in the next one. I think I'm going to have to try to catch it again in the next video. See you in a moment.